good encouraging message tonight. A lot of good things said. That was really good. And speaking of that massage thing, I did go to school 03, 04, somewhere around there, for a massage class. The only thing I didn't pass that one test in this Chinese medicine. Ooh. Went to College of Natural Health. Yeah. I dated a girl one time that she gave me plenty of problems. She said, "Well, you going to massage therapy school?" I said, "Yeah, man, I want to go in the medical side of it, maybe get in with a chiropractor." She said, "You gonna be rubbing pretty girls?" I said, "Yeah, that's part of it, and me in too." She didn't want to hear that men part. She gave me heck and heck. We broke up, we split, and so it's all good. But I still know my massage part, and I still know what clinic part I've asked, but I gotta know what you're talking about.
Chinese is hard.
Yeah, and but it was a good message, and that type of fear, I like how Pastor covered the fear.
Amen.
It's a negative fear and it's a positive fear. It's a negative fear that it's a positive fear that God say, "Don't step fear not to step outside of my commandments." That's a positive fear. But a negative fear is those group of people who say, "Well, I fear that I won't be good enough for God. I fear that I won't make it in His house. I fear that I can't do nothing good enough for Him." That's a negative fear. For the book of Revelations tell you that, I think it's about 21 and 22, the fearing, the whoremonger, and all that stuff, they second death is like, that's going to be the lake of fire. But that positive fear, I love that. Do not fear. Do not fear not to step outside of our Heavenly Father commandments. And they talk about nature. They talk about nations. Yeah, you know, we got to have a love for our nation. We got to have a love for one another. We got to have a love for one another. A Jesus type love, an inward type love, working its way on the outward side of it. Therefore, we could fellowship with a Haitian group, a Caucasian group. Don't make a difference what it is. Mexican, don't make no difference what it is. But I'm going to tell you something. I don't know if I ever shared a testimony with y'all tonight, but I will. I was in Lake Buena Vista, part of a Baptist church. Pretty cool church, all right church. But I'm going to tell you something. I used to have a bad prejudice and racism against Haitian people. You know, God took care of that one day. I worked for Disney World. God sent a Haitian lady to always ask me, "You know about God? You know about God?" Didn't want to hear from her talking to me about no God. He sent me, I got a job working part-time at Ramona's Macaroni Grill. This Haitian come up out of the back ATM. "Man, you know God? You know God?" "You know God? What you talking about?" "Talk to me about God. All y'all do is do voodoo, ain't that right?" And then I walked on. You know, God continued to chase me. My aunt married a Haitian fella. We said, "We'll let him slide." That's exactly what me and my brother said. God said, "Well, that's all right. That ain't good enough." One day, I met Uncle Lucky. Man, I love that man to death. But God said, "Ain't good enough." Well, then one day I went, I was walking, Scotty dropped me off at the convenience store, gas station. It's a cold night. She said, "You want to walk back home or you want me to take you home?" I said, "Take me home." Or I walk by, I don't care. She said, "Oh, there's a beautiful girl right there." I say, "Who is she?" And, you know, she began to describe her to me, long hair, pretty. She blacked her. I said, "Well, I don't use a tub of that kind, ma'am." That's exactly what I told her. And she said, "Don't be that way." And I said, "Okay." I get out and talk to the black girl. That's exactly what I told her. She said, "Don't be that way, brother." I got out, went inside the store, come out. Talked to that girl. She had the most beautiful accent I have. And she said, "Where you come from?" I say, "From church." I was one of them old Klan church people. Looked good in a suit. Heart deader than a deader in the hell hole. And let me tell you something. That girl began to tell me, "I'm a Sunday school teacher." Well, I began to want to talk to her and talk to her. I said, "Ma'am," something was in my heart beating. I said, "Where are you from?" Ask her where she's from. I thought, no, I just ignore, just talk. She said, "Ask her where she's from." I said, "Where are you from, ma'am?" She said, "You would never guess." I say, "Oh, yes, I will." I told them, I guess, I'd say, well, Jamaica, she said no. I'd say, well, Bahamas, she said no. I'd say, well, Virgin Islands, she said no, I'm from Haiti. Oh, I say, Haiti, man. She said, Haiti. I began to talk and talk, and we began to talk some more. I began to have compassion for her. I said, man, Ms. Cole, you need to go home. You're going to get sick. God took care of that stuff that night for me. I walked home. That was the most warm night I ever had. I walked home, fell by my bed and said, Lord, I thank you for what you showed me. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I thank you, Father, for Amen. What you showed me. Amen. God began to speak to me. Now you know what my word means. Love, love. If you're going to follow me, you're going to have a love for all nations. If you follow me and say you love me with all your heart, soul, mind, and strength, if that's what you say, you better start acting and walking it. And let me tell you, God took care of that, and that was a fun thing. That it was a blessing to my heart. Why? Because when I moved back down here to Highlands County, I went to this church right across from the baseball field. And right in the back there, it was a Haitian guy to take me around named Jonas, good Bible believing man too. And take me around, and me and him had a blast. Met his sister, and I told him, boy, your sister has a beautiful voice. I like that. And so God blessed me to have an understanding and have a love for all nations. He said, if you're going to be evangelizing and go out soul winning for me, you're going to love all what my hands have made. You're going to love from the foundation. I say, God, I thank you. God, I love you. God, show me to be much. I want to take, you know, I want to have more of his nature in me, more of his understanding, and to see through what you call a single eye. But you know, I like what we talked about tonight and different topics, but I want to look at Psalms 128. Psalms 128, it say this, a song of degrees. Blessed is everyone that feareth the Lord. That's talking about a good fear, not a negative fear. That's a good fear.
Reverence.
That's an awesome fear. That's a deep fear. You fear to walk outside what his commandments say. You fear to walk outside of his words. You fear to walk outside of this blessed book. It's a good fear to have.
Reverence.
That walketh in his ways. You notice it saying his ways. Mm-hmm. Therefore, when Jesus walked this earth in the flesh, yeah, he still walked in his heavenly Father ways. He still said, not my will, but the Father's will. Well, Jesus pretty could have had all types of ideals and ways to go. But still, my Father will, not mine. And blessed is he. You know what? I'm a blessed fellow today that I've been able to be amongst a handful of people, and especially this group, to open your eyes by the help of the Holy Spirit. We may not have everything right, but we have enough to open up our eyes spiritually. We have enough light to see through the clouds. We have enough light to see through the night. Blessed God, people don't have a light to see through the darkness. Praise God, he gave me that heavenly light to see through my own darkness, what was corrupting me. And he's still doing it. And I praise God for it. But it say here, blessed is everyone that feareth the Lord, that walketh in his ways. 128:2. For thou shalt heap the labor of thine hands, happy shalt thou be, and it shall be well with thee. 128:3. Thy wife shall be as a fruitful vine by the sides of the house, and thy children like all those plants, or how you say, around the tables? Did I get that part right? You know what that's talking about? When we in a church as a whole, I'm talking about male and female, church as a bride that's surrounding Christ's table, that's when we'll begin to feed and learn from one another. For what this sister have, I may not have. Then get up and share it. For what that brother have, I might be lacking. Get up and share it. You know what? I might have some mental spiritual play here that can feed him, feed her. That's what we need to do in the business of helping one another. How are we going to help one another? We're going to have to fear his commandments. Stay within him and tell that negative fear, flee me. Why? Because you're shortening me. God will direct and guide us. If we got a church here that's surrounded here, that have Christ in the mix, praise God for that bride. That's us. I believe the church, I believe us who's saved and born again, we are the bride of Christ. I believe that. And praise God that we surrounded by, I got his table right here in my hand. You got your Bible, you got the table. You have his Bible and his understanding, and you come here to meet, guess what? We sit around the big table, the live altar. Christ is the very altar himself. You know what? We can throw scriptures and nuggets out across that altar. We can work as satellites and it bounce off of one another. And we could either receive or you don't have to receive. And we could be like the children, sitting around the table, growing up, nurtured of Christ. And praise God for ministry that won't defeat, that won't that steal away to Jesus, that want to hear from him, and then throw it out across the floor. So food that's valuable for us, food that's going to help us. I'm talking about nutritious food, spiritual food. Praise God. Say here, behold, that thus the man shall be blessed that feareth the Lord. The Lord shall bless thee out of Zion, and thou shalt see the good of Jerusalem all the days of thy life. You know what? We can see the good of Jerusalem right here all the days of our life on this side of Israel. Praise God. And I thank God, for what he's about to do for this house and what's he doing and what we done learned. But we are the ones that prepare this side of Jerusalem. Understand? Man, say right here, the Lord shall, whatever, bless you out of Zion, and shall see the good of Jerusalem all the days of thy life. 128:6, yea, thou shalt see thy children, and peace upon Israel. And that's where it ends. And peace upon Israel. You know what? In a church like this, it is peace upon this side of Israel. Why? Because we strive, we dig, we share, we correct, we feed, we help, we love on one another, and praise God for that. That's what we're supposed to be doing. And praise God for everything I heard tonight. It's been beautiful to me, and I really, really love what I heard tonight. It blessed me. I just want to say that. Thank you. God bless.
Yeah. Thank you, Lord.